हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई प्रभा शर्मा वेलकम यू टू द नेक्स्ट पार्ट बी ऑफ क्लास अकाउंटेंसी 12 यूनिट 4. दिस यूनिट रिलेटेड विद द एनालिसिस ऑफ द फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट एंड हैविंग द फ्यू कंटेंट्स. आउट ऑफ दैट द फर्स्ट कंटेंट इज द फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट ऑफ कंपनीज. सो दीज आर द पार्ट्स रिलेटेड विद द फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट्स ऑफ कंपनी. And today I will tell you about the meaning of the financial statements and the objectives of the financial statements. Now you may see the concept of the financial statement. As the name is the financial statement, the financial statement are the basics and the formal annual reports through which the corporate organizations and the management communicates financial information to the different users like owners and the external users, which includes investors, tax authorities, governments and employees, etc. as external users. The financial statements normally refers to the statement of balance sheet at the end of one accounting period and the statement of profit and loss related with the same accounting period of a company. But nowadays, cash flow statement is also be taken as a integral part of the financial statement. So, as a part of, I'm telling you, the financial statements are the end products of the accounting process. They provide information about the profitability of the business as well as the financial positions of the business. Now, as per Company Act 2013, financial statement in relation to the company, it includes balance sheet at the end of one financial year, statement of profit and loss of the one financial year, cash flow statement of the one financial year, and then the if there is a need of a statement of change in equity, and if required, then the explanatory notes also. But the one person company and the small company, dormitory company also, they are exempted to prepare cash flow statement along with the financial statements. Now I am telling you about the for the company, what is financial year. Financial year is reference to the period of 1st April to the 31st March every year. As per the Company Act 2013, that means the every organization consists with the company has to use financial year. And now I'm moving to the next, the objective of the financial statements. Financial statements provides the information to the different users. Users may be the internal users of the company as well as to the external users of the company, for understanding the profitability as well as the financial positions of any business company related with the assets and liabilities, which provide to the users to take the decision accordingly, their interest. And the primary objective of the financial statement is to assist the users in decision making. Now the few specific objectives are listed here. To provide, number one, to provide the information about the economic resources and the obligations of a business. So it refers to provide the information to the investors and the external parties also who have the limited authority, ability and the resources to obtain the information. Economy resources is referring to assets in the organization and obligations referring to the liabilities of the company. Next point is to provide the information about the earning capabilities of the business. Earning capabilities refers to the profit and loss and the trading account, which refers to the so many kind of the earning capacity and which can be utilized to predict and compare and evaluate the business firms earning capabilities within the business and with the outside the business concern. Next point is to provide the information about the cash flows. That means this refers to compare and evaluate the position of the cash inflows and outflows in the terms of amount, timing, and the if any uncertainties related with receiving the cash, all are to be predicted by the cash flow statement. The next one is to judge the effectiveness of the management. This also provides the information how effectively the resources are utilized, how the costs are controlling by the management. Next one is to provide the information about the activities of the business affecting the society, because the business is the part of the society. So this also which is can be determined with the measurement and the important in the contributions towards the society environment. And the last one is to disclose the accounting policies. Financial statement also disclose the concepts followed in the process of accounting and the changes taken away or the methods going to be changed to during the one particular year. That means to be understand by these statements in a better way. So I think these are the basic objectives of the financial statements: to provide economic resources and the obligations, and provide the earning capabilities, and provide the cash flow statements, cash flow results, inflows and outflows, and judge the effectiveness of the management, and then the activities of the business towards the society, and the last is disclosing the policies and what which kind of the values arise through the objectives of the financial statement. That means as per the Company Act 2013, the financial statement of the company provides true and fair position of the statement of affairs of the company. Statement of affairs refers to the balance sheet. And the second is compiling the accounting standards as per the sections and subsections, and then the norms of the companies as per 2013 are followed. Related with the accounting standard 3 for the cash flow statement. Thank you. And all these are part of related with, and now go through. Thank you.